We begin in the roaring 20s in San Jose with a Greek-Italian family by the name of Dalis, who lived on Del Mas Avenue. This was a time when Santa Clara Valley was filled with farmers and ranchers, and the original Fox California Movie Theater was one of the newest buildings in downtown San Jose. The Dalises were a musical family. All played instruments, including Yvonne. Her sister, Marge, was the most influential person in her life and was the driving force in her career. Yvonne attended San Jose High School playing piano and became a music major at San Jose State College, now University. Miss Dalis was accepted to Columbia University and obtained a master's degree in music education. After Columbia, she returned to San Jose to give a vocal concert that Marge had organized. It was a sellout success, and from that point, she began to focus solely on the voice, working with Edith Walker in New York.
My purpose in leaving San Jose was to go to New York to get my master's degree in music education. I never planned to be a singer. I really didn't ever dream of being an opera singer. My family thought it'd be a good idea for me to study voice in New York just because they had heard the best voice teachers in the world were in New York, with no idea of being an opera singer. After 2 years of studying in New York and realizing that there really was a voice there, I did apply for a Fulbright Award and won. I won a Fulbright Award that sent me to Milano. So I was sent to the Giuseppe Verdi Conservatory of Music, and after 2 years with him, I did one audition and received my first contract.
Ms. Dalis was offered a contract to perform in residence with a German regional company in Oldenburg, which she used as the model for Opera San Jose, the only residential opera company in America. It was also in Milan that she was earmarked by the Metropolitan Opera and given the stage name Irena by general manager Rudolf Bing.
Well, they talked me into believing that I could maybe make a difference. I kept saying I was not a teacher, but he said, no, somebody with your background is the type we need in a university system, particularly in the vocal department.
I got a full professorship for her. She came and started an opera workshop on the faculty in the music school. And out of this, in the years that followed, on her own, came Opera San Jose.
They stay 4 years. They leave with 16 leading roles, any one of which they could do on 12 hours' notice. That's valuable. The real satisfaction for me is to watch our singers develop. You can train a singer in a studio, but you cannot develop performance abilities without performing. And when I see that breakthrough happen, you would think it happened to me. I'd be thrilled, really thrilled, to see, now he or she has found himself and they're comfortable.
Thank you.
that's when the real inspiration comes in, and that's when you see the artistry. And when I see that develop, of course, that's my pay.
This opera company could not have developed if I didn't have the complete support from this community. And it's been incredible, because when I first started this, I had friends from New York call me and say, you know, you're out of your mind, this will never work. That the community has accepted the fact that our mission is to develop artists. That is what we do. We do not import stars, we export stars.